Hello students, welcome to my channel Crack Chemistry. Before starting, I request you to please subscribe my channel and press the like button. Students, I also request you to please press the bell icon for getting updates. Students, today I am going to cover a class 12 topic, SN2 reactions of haloalkanes. This topic is present in NCERT Part 2, Unit 10. The name of the unit is Haloalkanes and Haloarenes. This topic is extremely important from your board point of view as well as for your competitive exams point of view. So students, let's see what we are going to discuss today. Today we will discuss about chemical reactions of haloalkanes. We will discuss about nucleophilic substitution reactions. We will discuss about types of nucleophilic substitution reactions. We will discuss about substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reactions. Mechanism of SN2 reactions. We'll discuss about inversion of configuration, order of reactivity of alkyl halides towards SN2 reactions. Some questions we will discuss. So now we'll see what are the chemical reactions of haloalkanes. So students, the reactions of haloalkanes may be divided into following categories. Category first is the nucleophilic substitution reaction. Nucleophilic substitution reactions of haloalkanes again are of two types. First is SN2 reaction. SN2 stands for substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reaction. Second is SN1 reaction. Then the second type of reaction is elimination reactions. Third is a reaction with metals. So students, today I will cover only the SN2 reactions. For the remaining reactions, you please watch my next videos. Then we'll see nature of the CX bond. Students, in the case of haloalkanes, as the halogen atom is more electronegative. Halogen atom being more electronegative. Polarizes the CX bond. What does it mean? It means that as the halogen atom is more electronegative, it will withdraw electron pairs of bonds, electron pair of the CX bond towards itself, as a result of which it will acquire partial negative charge, which I am showing with the help of the sign delta negative, and the carbon will acquire a partial positive charge. So because of the higher electronegativity of halogen atom, the CX bond, we have seen that it becomes polarized. CX bond is polarized here. Now we will see the nucleophilic substitution reactions. Students, there are two types of nucleophilic substitution reactions. So before starting, first of all, we will see what is a nucleophile. Nucleophiles are electron-rich species. So those species which have extra electron, which are electron-rich, are called as nucleophiles. Then where they will attack? As they are electron-rich, so definitely they will attack that part of the substrate molecule which is electron-deficient, or we can say at the positive, which possesses the positive charge. Then what are nucleophilic reactions? The reactions in which a nucleophile replaces already existing nucleophile in a molecule is called as nucleophilic substitution reactions. So now we will see about the nucleophilic substitution reactions of haloalkanes. So students, in the nucleophilic substitution reaction, I just want to take a simple example here. I am writing here nucleophile by the symbol NU. As it is electron rich, it is having a negative charge. It attacks haloalkanes. So haloalkanes, it attacks. Just now we have seen that as the CX bond becomes polarized, so nucleophile is having electrons. It is electron-rich species. So where it will attack, to which part of the haloalkane it will attack? Definitely which has the carbon charge. So nucleophile will attack the positively charged carbon atom of the haloalkane and will replace the halogen atom and will take the place of halogen atom. So halogen atom is leaving here in the form of halide ion. So which is called as leaving group. This is called as leaving group. Now we will see about the some of the important nucleophiles here. Student, this is a NCERT table. This table is present in your NCERT textbook, and here very nicely they are giving you the reagent and the nucleophile which is provided by the reagent, and what is the substitution product, and finally the class of main product. So you can see here, if you are treating your haloalkane with NaOH or with KOH, the nucleophile provided will be OH minus, and the product form will be ROH, which belongs to alcohol. Similarly, if you are treating it with water, the nucleophile provided will be H2O, the product will be ROH, again alcohol. So in the same way, they are giving you a series of nucleophiles and the reagents which give these nucleophiles and the final product. So student, it is compulsory for you to memorize this table. You can see here, for example, if you want to replace halogen by cyanide group, you have to treat it with KCN. If you have to replace halogen by isocyanide, you have to treat the your haloalkane with AgCN. So now we will see some of the reactions based on the table which we have discussed just now. Students, just now we have seen that if you want to replace halogen of haloalkane by alcohol, what you have to do, you have three choices available with you. You can treat haloalkane either with NaOH or with KOH or with water. So your product will be ROH and halogen will be leave as NaX. Similarly, if you have to replace your RX by cyanide nucleophile, you have to treat it with potassium cyanide. The product will be RCN, alkyl cyanide plus KX. Then if you have to replace X by isocyanide, what you have to do? You have to treat it with silver cyanide. The product will be RNC plus KX. So now we will see about the ambidentate nucleophile. Hey students, what are ambidentate nucleophile? Ambidentate nucleophiles, they possess two nucleophilic centers. Ambidentate nucleophiles possess two nucleophilic centers. Example I am writing here. Examples are cyanides and nitrites. So how they possess two nucleophilic centers, I am going to show with the help of their resonance structures. So cyanide group can be written as a resonance hybrid of the following resonating structures. Here you can see that nitrogen atom bears a lone pair of electron, carbon also a lone pair of electron plus a negative charge. Then the another resonating structure is one in which carbon double bond N. Carbon is having a lone pair of electron and nitrogen is having two lone pair of electrons and a negative charge. So students, always remember that whenever a nucleophile attaches itself with carbon, the product is cyanide. And whenever it attaches itself with nitrogen, the product is isocyanide. Similarly, one more ambidentate nucleophile I am going to write here, that is O-N double bond O. O is having a negative charge and the nitrogen atom has a lone pair. So this is the nitrite group. Whenever alkyl group attaches itself to the nitrogen, the product is nitroalkane. And whenever the alkyl group attaches itself through oxygen, the product is alkyl nitrite. Now we will see a very important question which is based on the same discussion. This is from your NCERT textbook. The students, the question is that haloalkanes with KCN form alkyl cyanide as the main product, whereas AgCN forms isocyanide. So what is the reason for that? Students, potassium cyanide always forms cyanides, alkyl cyanides with haloalkanes. So KCN is an ionic compound. Potassium cyanide being an ionic compound, it provides cyanide ion. It gives cyanide ions. And just now we have seen that cyanide ions have two nucleophilic centers. So cyanide ions possess two nucleophilic centers. One is at carbon and one is at nitrogen. So you know that from your previous class knowledge that carbon-carbon bond is a very strong bond. Carbon-carbon bond is a very strong bond. So because of the very strong carbon-carbon bond, the alkyl group attaches itself with the carbon. So alkyl group attaches itself with carbon, giving cyanides as a product. Now we will see about, I hope it is clear to you. Just now I have discussed with you, as KCN is an ionic compound, it gives cyanide ions in the solution. Cyanide ion possess two nucleophilic center, one is the carbon and one is nitrogen. But alkyl group attaches itself with the carbon. Why? The reason is that carbon-carbon bond is a very strong bond. So therefore, alkyl group attaches itself with carbon of the cyanide group and the products are cyanides. Now we will see about the silver cyanide. Student, silver cyanide is a covalent compound. So silver cyanide, being a covalent compound, doesn't provide cyanide ions in the solution. So now you can see that what is the only thing which is available for bonding? Only nitrogen is available for bonding. So therefore, what will be the product? Product will be isocyanide. So students, I hope it is clear to you. Then next we are going to discuss the mechanism of substitution reactions. Students, the reaction takes place by two different ways. I discussed already with you. One is SN2, that is substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reaction, and one is SN1 reaction, which we will discuss in our next video. So SN2 reaction, the reaction between, what are SN2 reactions? SN2 reactions are those reactions where the rate depends on the concentration of both the reactants. So these reactions are called as SN2 reactions. SN2 reactions means rate of the reaction depends on concentration of both the reactants. So now we will see some example of SN2 reaction. See, here this is the hydroxide ion, where OH acts as a nucleophile and oxygen atom bears a negative charge. It attacks the carbon atom of the haloalkane. And carbon atom, all the three hydrogen I am showing like this, the thick wedge represents the bond which is projecting towards you, and the dotted line, it represents the bond which is behind the plane of the paper, and the normal bond, it represents the bond in the plane of the paper. So when hydroxide ion approaches haloalkanes, what happens? The following interesting thing starts taking place. The carbon is attached to three hydrogen atoms. Simultaneously, two processes are taking place here. Formation of a new bond starts taking place here, which I am showing with the help of this dotted line. And similarly, the formation of a new old CCl bond starts breaking here. So we have seen that two processes are taking place simultaneously. The new COH bond formation is taking place, and here the old CCl bond breaking is taking place. Now, this is a transition state. It is highly unstable, and this changes to give the product. What is our product? Product we can see here. C. In the product, OH will be attached to the side opposite to that of chlorine. Then these are the three hydrogens attached to carbon atom. Plus we will have the chlorine, which is left as a leaving group. So students, I hope this is clear to you. Now the same thing can be written in the form of, or can be represented in the form of a diagram. Here you can see that the red ball represents the incoming hydroxide ion. It attacks the molecule of haloalkane. This is the transition state form. And here you can see that green ball represents the outgoing halide ion. Now, what we will see, just now we have discussed about the SN2 reaction. In this case, we have seen that a nucleophile approaches carbon atom of haloalkane. And we have seen that two processes are taking place here. What are the two processes? First process was that a new bond. What was the new bond? Between C and OH. Between C and oxygen of OH started taking place. And one more thing we have seen, that old one. Between carbon and halogen. Carbon and halogen, we have taken chlorine here. So carbon and chlorine starts breaking. So two processes are taking simultaneously. Student, this is a very important point. The two processes are taking place simultaneously in a single step, and no intermediate is formed here. This point you have to keep in your mind. I'm repeating, these two processes are taking place simultaneously in a single step and no intermediate is formed. And as the reaction progresses, what will happen? Bond between the nucleophile and the carbon atom starts forming, and the bond between the carbon and leaving group weakens. Now, what will happen at this stage? At this stage, a very interesting thing is taking place here, students. At this stage, the configuration of carbon atom under attack inverts. So, I'm writing here, configuration of carbon atom under attack inverse. And this inversion we can compare with a very interesting example. So the configuration of carbon atom under attack inverse in a similar way as an umbrella. As an umbrella turned inside out. As an umbrella turned inside out. When caught in a strong wind. So this is a very important characteristic of SN2 reaction, that inversion of configuration takes place during SN2 reaction. I hope it is clear to you. So what happens during the inversion of configuration? Configuration of carbon atom under attack inverts, just like an umbrella turned inside out when it is caught in a strong wind. Now, we will discuss about another important factor. We are going to discuss about the reactivity of alkyl halides towards SN2 reactions. I'm writing here, reactivity of alkyl halides. Reactivity of alkyl halides towards SN2 reaction. So, students, just now we have seen that during SN2 reaction, alkyl halide approaches a positively charged carbon atom. So, when the approach of we have seen that a nucleophile approaches a positively charged carbon atom of the haloalkane. So, when the approach of nucleophile will be easy, when the carbon atom to which halogen is attached is not bulky. It consists of some simple groups. So, in the case of methyl group, we can see that the carbon atom of the haloalkane is attached to only 3 halogen atoms. But in the case of ethyl, we can say that it is attached to 2 halogen atoms plus 1 methyl group. In the case of isopropyl, which is 2 degree secondary alkyl halide, the carbon which is attached to halogen is attached to 2 alkyl group plus 1 hydrogen. So, we can see that bulkiness around the carbon of the atom of the halogen increases as we are moving from methyl to ethyl to isopropyl, and finally we are coming to the tertiary butyl. In the tertiary butyl group, we can say that the carbon to which halogen is attached to 3 bulky alkyl groups. So now, students, I hope it is clear to you where the attack of nucleophile can be easily it can attack in the case of methyl. So I'm writing here, methyl group undergoes SN2 reaction at the highest rate, followed by ethyl 1 degree, or in place of ethyl I can write here 1 degree, then followed by isopropyl is a 2 degree, I'm writing here 2 degree or secondary, and in the last we have the tertiary butyl, which is the 3 degree. So student, this is a very important point. You have to keep in your mind that what is the order of reactivity of different alkyl halides towards SN2 reaction. Methyl, highest rate, followed by ethyl, which is 1 degree, then isopropyl, which is 2 degree, and finally we have the tertiary butyl, which is 3 degree. Now students, I want to discuss a question based on the same concept. This question is from your NCERT textbook. Student, the question is that they are giving you two compounds here. One is, both are the cyclic compounds, and the another compound is cyclohexyl chloride. So out of these compounds, which will undergo SN2 reaction at a faster rate, they are asking. So you can see that first we have to see the nature of carbon atom, whether it is 1 degree, 2 degree or 3 degree. So students, this compound first, chlorine atom is attached to the carbon atom. This carbon atom, you can see, is attached to only one carbon atom. So this compound is of 1 degree, H11CH2Cl is a 1 degree alkyl halide. It's a cyclic halide. And in this case, you can see the chlorine atom is attached to carbon, which is attached to two other. I'm just writing with the help of this red line. You can look at this carbon atom. This is attached to two carbon atoms. So therefore, here you can see that this is a 2 degree alkyl halide. And just now we have seen that out of 1 degree and 2 degree, which undergo SN2 reaction at the fastest rate, 1 degree. So what is the answer here? This 1 degree alkyl halide will undergo SN2 reaction at the fastest rate. This is our answer. Now I am discussing about the second question. In the second question, they have given you two compounds having same number of carbon atom. First is the having iodine as a halogen. Second is having chlorine as a halogen. So I discussed with you whose size is larger out of chlorine and iodine. Iodine atomic size is larger than chlorine. So iodine is a better leaving group. Because its size is larger, it's a better leaving group. Students, always remember this point. As we move down the group, atomic size increases. When atomic size increases, the bond length also increases. So iodine being a larger in size, it is a better leaving group due to its large size. So now you know the answer. Due to its large size. So students, now you know the answer, which will undergo SN2 reaction at the fastest rate. In case of these two compounds, our compound is this iodoalkane. It will undergo SN2 reaction at the faster rate. Now students, we will see whatever we have studied today. We have discussed today chemical reactions of haloalkanes, nucleophilic substitution reactions, type of nucleophilic substitution reactions, substitution, nucleophilic bimolecular reactions, mechanism of SN2 reactions, inversion of configuration and order of reactivity of alkyl halides towards SN2 reactions, and we have discussed some questions based on the topic. So I hope every point is clear to you, students. In case of any doubt, please post your doubts in the comment box. Thank you so much. Please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.